before we will see the concept of what is meant by Gauss law and applications for the Gauss law, as well as the electrical potential and as well as the electrical potential due to the gradient. And we will see there some simple questions based on the electric gradient, right? Now let's see the another important concept, that will be the dipole. Okay, this dipole concept is the very important. From this dipole concept only we will make some important conclusions. From that important conclusions we will have to be moved to the further concept I will be tell in this session. Okay, here you can see what will be the electric dipole. That be the an electric dipole is formed when two point charges of equal magnitude. Okay, here what have to be considered, I will be considered the point charges which have the equal magnitude but opposite sign. Okay, that point charges has to be the opposite sign, separated by this small distance d. Okay, if you want to represent this whatever the theory I have to be represented here in terms of the diagrammatic representation, let's see what will happen here. If you observe one thing, I will be taken okay, this be my x axis, and similarly this be my y axis, and this be my z axis. Okay, in this x y z axis coordinate system I will be take point P. Okay, so for example if I take this be my point P. Okay, this be my point P, and here you can observe this be my origin. From the origin to my point P, what will be the distance? The distance will become the r. Okay, the distance will become the r. And similarly here what they will be tell, you have to be consider your two point charges of equal magnitude. The magnitude must be the same but opposite sign. Here if you want to represent it perfectly, this be my plus q charge, and similarly this be my minus q charge. Okay, this be for plus z axis and this be for minus z axis. Okay, and from 0 to plus q I will be taken my distance be the d by 2. From 0 to plus q I will be taken my distance be the d by 2. Okay, and similarly from 0 to minus p minus q I will be taken my distance be the similarly d by 2. So what will be the total distance? The total distance will become the d by 2 plus d by 2, that will become the 2d by 2. So here you can see, so d by 2 plus d by 2, so this will become the 2d by 2. So how much the total distance? The total distance will become the d. And here you can see how much my total distance, my total distance will become the d. Okay, from this point we have to be clear. Next, from plus q to I will be draw in one straight line towards the p. I will be make that the distance be the r1. Okay, I will be taken plus q to this point p, I will be taken this distance be r1. And similarly from minus q to plus p I will be make another straight line. Okay, I will be make another straight line and I will be taking this distance be the my r2. Okay, and here you can observe both of three be the different straight lines, right? Okay, here my important conclusion be the, here if you can observe here I will be consider this be my angle some theta. Okay, what will happen to this distance? This may be my target. find out the how much the distance that's be my target. In order to get that distance, I will be tell you the one shortcut for this. You have to be applied that shortcut whenever you have to be study any type of textbook, like a Sadiku textbook. They will be directly tell the d cos theta like that here there. Most of the students, whenever I will be tell you the lot of students of this electromagnetic subject, generally they will get doubt of how they will be get this d cos theta there. Okay, if you directly open the textbook also, you will get that doubt. I will be just clarify that doubt in a very precise way. Please listen this lecture carefully. Here you can see, for example, if I will be considered any two straight lines, okay, I will be considered any two straight lines. For example, if you see, this be my straight line 1, and for example, this be my straight line 2, this be my straight line 2, okay. Here you can see, this be my straight line 1 and this be my straight line 2. So my point of interest be the, what will be the extra distance that will be covered by the line 2, that's my point of interest. Here you can see, if you want to find out that, how you can find out, you just have to be draw the perpendicular, right? You just have to be draw the perpendicular. That means this angle must be the 90 degrees, and similar this angle must be the 90 degrees. Okay, and here you can see, this be my line 1 and this be my line 2. Here this be my extra portion, this be my extra portion. I have to be find out that how much that extra portion. Here also you can see, this be my so one line and this be my another line. From here onwards both will be the same, and here the distance of the R2 that will be the somewhat higher. Why? Because that be in the from minus Q to plus Q, the distance will be somewhat long compared to the plus Q to this point P, right? So in this case, what we have to do means, I will be taken, so here if I will be taken, this be my point of interest, right? Here I will be taken my, if you want to consider your this be your like an angle, okay, this be your angle. For example, this be my name it as in B, and this be my, I will be name it as in C, and this be I will be name it as in N. Okay, and here you can see, for example, if you consider this C to B distance, this be the, this will be form a triangle, right? Okay, and here you can see, this be the C B, and this be your N, this be your N, and this be your theta, and this be your 90 degrees. Okay, and here how you can apply your cos theta. I will be consider this my distance be the d, I will be consider this distance be the d. Okay, so if I want to apply the cos theta, what will happen? Cos theta that will be equal to cn divided by cb. So what will happen to the cn? That be the cn divided by, what will happen to the cb? Cb, the distance be the d. So what will happen to the cn? Cn is equal to d cos theta. Cn is equal to d cos theta. Okay, how much the distance from c to n? That be the c d cos theta, d cos theta. Next, what we have to do means, if we can apply our voltage across your point charge, what will be the formula for that? Here you can observe, if you want to apply your voltage V, that be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 divided by R. This be your point charge formula, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 divided by R. So what I have to do means, here we have the two straight lines, right? The radius not be the R, it will be divided into the R1 minus R2, right? So here how you can write, this be the Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 divided by r1 minus 1 divided by r2. Okay, this will become the q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. So this will become the, if you take the LCM for this, this will become the r2 minus r1 divided by r1 into r2. So here what will be the distance between r2 minus r1? R2 minus r1, that be equal to d into cos theta, right? And I will be considered r1. If I will be considered, assume that r1 my distance be the r, and similarly my r2 distance be the r, what will happen if I will be assume like that? Okay, r1 into r2, how much? This be the r into r, this will become the r square, right? Now I will be substitute r2 minus r1 place, that will be the d cos theta, in place of r1 into r2, that be the r square. So here you can see this will become the q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into d into cos theta divided by r1 into r2, that will become the r square. So this be the potential V. Okay, next, what we have to do means, now onwards, here one more thing you have to be considered. So this be the d into cos theta. So here this be the, so here if you see from zero, if you want to take your PP potential surface, or if you want to make your angle be like this, like, right, that be the zero. If you want to make your theta be the like this, this will become the zero. If you want to make your angle be the like this, this will become the 90 degrees. If you want to put your 90 degrees, that will become the total, will become the zero, cos 90, that will become the zero. There will be no choice of applying the 90 degrees. So you have to be must apply your theta be like this towards the zero. So in place of theta, you have to put your 0 degrees. So this will become the d. Okay, here if you consider your radial direction, what will happen? This will become the d ar bar, d ar bar. Okay, so substitute that. So v, that be equal to q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into d into ar bar divided by r square. Whenever you have to be c, q into d, that will be equal to the dipole moment. So whenever you have to be c, p is equal to q into d, that be the dipole moment. So this be the dipole moment, dipole moment. So dipole moment always lies from negative to positive, from negative to positive. Okay, now substitute that. So here V, that B equal to P into A bar R divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. Okay, for example, I will be considered this be my equation 1. Now what we have to do means, if I want to consider, it's not about the origin, the potential, that will be not about the origin. So what will happen? Not about the origin, not about the origin. So this will become the V of R, that will become the P into R minus R dash divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. If you apply the modulus, this will become the R minus R dash. Modulus means square will become the cube. V of R, that will be equal to P of R minus R dash divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R minus R dash whole cube. Okay. For example, if you want to apply for this analysis, what if you apply the electrical potential, what will happen? So here is my duster. Okay, here, so if you want to apply your electrical potential for this. What will be the formula for the electrical potential? Electrical potential formula E is equal to minus del V. Okay, E is equal to minus del V. For example, if I will be consider this point P in the spherical coordinate system. Okay, this point P in the spherical coordinate system. What will be the range of parameters for the spherical coordinate system? The range of parameters that be the r, comma, theta, comma, phi. This be my range of parameters for the spherical coordinate system. For example, if I will be taken E is equal to minus del V, so what will be the differential length for the spherical coordinate system? That be the minus of, how you can write this del dot V? This be the dou V by dou R into AR bar plus 1 divided by R into dou V by dou theta into A theta bar plus plus 1 divided by R into sin theta dou V by dou theta, this be the A phi bar. So here you can see this be the minus of, whenever you have to be considered, here you can see, here we have to be played with only radius, radius R be present, right? Radius R be present, and here if you want to take some angle theta, that be the cos theta, right? Some theta be present, but we can't play with the azimuthal angle, right? Here we don't have the need to play with the azimuthal angle, so you have to be taken your azimuthal angle phi be the 0. So here you can see, if you can take RB, yes, RB present, that be the radius, and as well as in theta, yes, theta be present, okay, and as well as n. If you want to take your phi, this be neglected. Why? Because means we don't have the uses of this phi, right? And here what will be the remaining? This be the dou v by dou r a r bar plus 1 divided by r dou v by dou theta a theta bar. Okay, so here minus of what will be the dou v by dou r, and what will be your v, and v be the q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into d cos theta divided by r square plus 1 divided by r into dou by into, so this be the a r bar, right? A r bar. So into this be the a r bar plus this be the dou by dou theta, 1 by r be present, right? 1 by r into dou by dou theta into q by 4 pi epsilon naught into d into cos theta divided by r square. Okay, so here you can see, if you want to do the differentiation with respect to the r, what will happen? This will become the, so dou by dou r of 1 divided by r square, how much differentiation? That be the minus 2 divided by r cube. Dou by dou r into 1 divided by r square, how much? This will become the minus 2 divided by r cube. So this will become the 2 into q into d cos theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube into a r bar plus, so here you can see 1 divided by r into r square, how much? R into r square, this will become the r cube. So if you want to do the differentiation with respect to the theta, this will become the sine theta. So this will become the minus sine theta q into d divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube, right? So into this will become the a theta bar. So here this will become the, if you want to take the qd divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube common, q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube common. This will become the 2 cos theta a r bar plus this be the sin theta a theta bar. Okay, this be your answer for the electric dipole. Okay, this be the answer for the electric dipole. So how much? V is equal to qd divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube into 2 into cos theta a r bar plus sin theta a theta bar. Okay, now let's see the some simple question based on this. How you can apply it in terms of problems, if you use the any problems based on the electric dipole, how we can use it. Let's see. Okay, question. So what the question they will be given? Two dipoles with dipole moments. Two dipoles with dipole moments. Minus five AZ bar nanocoulomb per meter, and they will be given and 9 AZ bar nanocoulomb per meter are located at points. So the points they will be given, that be the 0, -2 as well as the and 0, 0, 3 respectively. Find the potential at the origin. Okay, this was the question that will be given. So here you can see what they will be asked. Two dipoles which they will be given, dipole moments they will be given 5 minus 5 AZ bar nanocoulomb per meter and as well as the 9 AZ bar nanocoulomb per meter are located at the points. They will be given 0, -2 and the next point that will be the 0, 0, 3 respectively. You have to be find out your potential at the origin. You already know what will be the potential at the origin. So here you can see B equal to, here we have the two charges, right? So that will be the summation of, for example, if I take R, so R is equal to 1 to 2, so PR. So for example, if I will be take K, okay, what will happen? You will not get confused whenever you will be taking the R, okay? PK, RK divided by 4 pi epsilon naught RK square, okay? How you can divide this? This will become the P1 R1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R1 square plus this will be the P2 R2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R2 square. Okay, similarly, what will be the point P1 they will be given? Point P1 that will be the minus 5 into nano means 10 to the power of minus 9 into what will be your R1. You have to be find out your R1. So here you can see R1, that will be equal to what? What will be the find out the potential? You have to find out your potential at the origin, right? That will become your final point. So this will become the 0, 0, 0 minus, if you want to find out your position vector, what will happen? Minus given point, that be the, for the first R1, that be the 0, 0, -2. So this will become the 2. R1 is equal to how much? That will be the 2. If you apply the modulus of R1, this will become the 2 a z bar. Okay, similarly, if you want to find out the R2, R2, that be equal to your, whenever you have to be find out your potential at that point, that will be equal, become your final point. Whatever the points in the given, that will be your initial points. Even here you can see, you have to be find out your potential at the origin. That means your origin will become the final point. And what will be the dipole moments they will be given of the represented points, that will be the 0, 0, 3, that will become your initial points. So here you can see, this will become the 0, 0, 0 minus, here this will become the 0, 0, 3. So this will become the -3. So if you apply the modulus, this will become the 3. If you apply the modulus, this will become the 3. This will also be the A Z bar. And similarly, here you can see what will happen to your R1. R1 be the 2 divided by, so 4 pi into, this be the 8.85 into 10 to the power of -12 into what will be your R1 square. R1 square, that be the 2 whole square. Okay. Plus, what will be your P2? P2 be the, I think we will make mistake, this be the cube, right? This be the cube. Yes. Now this be the, okay. So here, what will be your P2? P2 be the 9, right? 9 into 10 to the power of -9 into what will be your R2? R2 will become the -3 divided by, and this be the 4 pi into, this be the 8.85 into 10 to the power of -12 into 3, this be the 3 cube. Okay, this be the -3 whole cube. Okay, if you just open the calc and put it to the answer, how much you will get? You will get your answer be the -20.25 volts. -20.25 volts. This be your answer for this electric dipole question. Okay, this is the important concept. Most of the students will get confused whenever they try to solve the what will be the electric dipole. And this concept is somewhat useful in the whenever we have to be used the method of images. Okay, this type of scenarios we have to be used, whatever the plus Q as well as the minus Q charges, how you can use it there also, we can use it, that type of scenarios in the method of images. Okay, in the next class we will try to see what will be the energy density. Okay, energy density, and as well as the, we will try to see some of problems based on the energy density. If you really like this video, please like my video, share my video, as well as the subscribe to my YouTube channel.